All right, welcome everybody to the tape room. My name's Hugh McCutcheon. I'm the volleyball coach here at the University of Minnesota. And with me today, we have CeCe McGraw and Adonna Rollins. We're gonna talk a little bit about serving and passing. The point of our discussion today is to try to give you a few ideas into some of the strategies that we've tried to use. We think that serving and passing is a really critical element of the game. CeCe is obviously an extremely accomplished libero, and Adonna has been a great outside hitter for us, six rotation outside for the last 2 years. And so we thought that they were a really good pairing for this discussion. They both have to execute on both sides of this equation, serving and passing. So we're really excited to have them with us and honored to have their input and expertise on the topic. So the goal for us in terms of serving strategy is not necessarily aces, although we certainly enjoy them, but that's not the goal. The goal is to try to knock teams out of system, to try to attack seams or spaces around passers so that we're having to defend fewer hitters rather than more hitters. And from a passing point of view, obviously, we're trying to keep the ball in play. I mean, the first goal is to not get aced, but then in addition, the better pass we can create, the better first contact we can have, the more offensive options we have, and then the easier it is for our setters to create space and for our hitters to attack space. So anyway, that's kind of the theories behind all of it, the method behind the madness, if you will. Without further ado, we'll jump in here. What we're going to do is look at a few serves first. As I said, we're trying to get into seams and spaces. There's a variety of ways that we try to do that. You know, we might try to get into a seam or into a space or into an edge over here. We might kind of drop over the top of someone, try to get them short. Lots of different things that we're trying to do, or push them deep into the corners. Basically anything other than put it right in their lap. So we'll start with a serve here from Adonna. And here we go. Really nice little dropper. So Adonna, tell me about that serve. What kind of things were you thinking, and what kind of stuff were you trying to do?
I think mainly for that serve, since it was a little bit short, I think I was really focusing on my toss, getting it over to my right shoulder so I could place it where I wanted to, and also getting my fourth step in the line so I could also be able to put it where I want it.
Yeah, straight lines, right? It's amazing how keeping everything lined up allows for greater accuracy. Good stuff. Here we are at home, working an outside edge. And similar stuff, Adonna, there?
Yes, I just think on this one, I kind of hit it away more than I wanted.
Mm-hmm.
But I think everything else, like my feet and toss, were in the right positioning.
Yeah, I'd agree. You cut it a little bit, but that actually led it to drift out to the sideline. We made it a pretty effective serve. CeCe, we got a couple of you here. So let's play it in real time, and then you can chat to us maybe when we get into slow-mo. Away we go. CeCe, what do you got?
So this one, I was just really focused on basically lining it up, obviously trying to get into good space where the front row outside was with that middle back passer. Okay. So really forcing her to cover that deep corner. So really just with the intent of making good contact, getting that toss out in front of me and hitting a straight line to the deep shot.
Yeah, and it's really well executed into that deep five corner. And then you've got the bro kind of coming across to take that. But you're also, you know, the outside is kind of getting pulled a little bit out too. And it's a nice spot to disrupt, and certainly knocks them out of system. So a good serve. Here's another one. You can talk us through that again.
So this one, this is something that I kind of started doing last season, but I would start up like lining up cross court.
Yeah.
Pretty much to 5-6, and then I'd end up straightening it out to hit it down to 1-6 and try to drop it in the seams, hit in between people. And with that one against, was that Maryland?
Yeah. Uh-huh.
Basically just trying to stay tall. I think I still kind of leaned quite a bit, but I kind of had the intent to stay tall so that I could make good contact to get that nice drop serve on the bro.
Yeah, and got into some good seam space there too. Here's another one, I think. Had some speed and some drop. That's a tough thing to find.
Yeah, so that one, I mean, they had a two-person serve receive, so just really trying to work that seam in between them and make a move for it.
And for both of you, obviously you're the ones out there doing it, right? And we talk all the time about, you know, working edges, working seams, serving the space. You know, as servers, you know, how do you feel about, one, that as a strategy, and then two, your ability to be able to execute that? So just maybe, Adana, you start, and then we'll follow with CeCe.
I think being able to do it just goes back to my feet for me and also my toss. I think toss and feet for me is, like, how I am able to be accurate and consistent with where I serve. So I think those are my two, like, main things. So if they're not correct, then not usually the serve won't go where I'm intending it to go.
Cease, what do you think?
I think for me personally, my toss is, like, the most important thing. Really making sure I'm getting it out on my right-hand side, because the more it gets to my left side, the more I lean. Mm-hmm. And I think it's important to be able to stay tall and have your body be, like, constant through contact when you're serving, because it'll give you a better result and you'll get more consistent contact.
Sure. Yeah, and that lean, you know, then you end up kind of cutting the ball and getting across the line a little bit, and it's harder to control it, no question. And I agree. I think, you know, the way you're lining up with your feet and the toss leading to a really clean moment of contact matters, and making sure that you're hitting it good. You know, that's the goal. All right. Well, now we're going to get onto the other side of the ball and into some reception here. You know, passing is, you know, concurrently simple, but it's really complicated in that, you know, the moment of contact, it's about getting your platform there and making a good angle so that we can have a chance to sit. But to do that, there's a lot of factors that you've got to put in the mix. One is obviously getting a good look at the server, seeing the toss, seeing contact, trying to get a little bit ahead of it, trying to get a good read on the server so maybe you can get a good first step in the line. And then, of course, you got to move, you know, side to side, short, deep, whatever it is, to get in a good position to make good contact relative to where the ball is in relation to your body. And so what tends to happen is a lot of passers wait a long time before they actually move and make the decision about where they're going to go. And ultimately, I think that ends up with people kind of swinging outside the line a ton. When if they could get a good read, if they could see things and I don't know, process that information a little more quickly, they could get in the line a little sooner and do kind of the big work first and then just worry about making the right angle versus worrying about getting to the spot and making the right angle and having that happen all at the same time. So here we go. A nice move there, Dee Dee.
I think for this one, I had a lead leg, but I think I could have stepped more forward instead of to the side. But mm-hmm. I think I was in the line with the ball, though. But I just think it could have been forward instead of to the side, and that's something I'm working on. So,
yeah, I'd agree. I mean, we're talking about degrees of efficiency here, but I think, yeah, you could have been a little more forward. But at contact, I thought you were, you know, forward and balanced, and that's what we want. So, yeah, good stuff. And I like you stepping into that seam and getting in there early so you can make that good angle. That was a good. How about that one?
For that one, I think I was forward and I beat the ball to where it was.
Yeah.
So I think that was a good.
Yeah. And I also like the way you set up to that. You know, when the serve's coming from five and you're passing in five, the fact that you're squared up perpendicular to the line of that serve coming from five to five versus being parallel to the net, I think that's really important relative to getting in the line and making a good angle. So that was good too. All right. Here's another one.
I think that was a good example of balance and forward. I really stuck that one, I felt like.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And I was facing the server, so it made it easier to read the ball.
Yeah. You know, and it may be a little swingy, but in the heat of the moment, you know, who knows? Tracking the ball when it's moving and it's floating is hard to do. But I agree. I thought you got there and you were nice and balanced at contact. So some good stuff. All right.
That one, I think I stepped to the side again, but I think I was still in line with the ball. And I think I could have led with my arms a bit for that one. I kind of committed my platform a bit early.
Right. Yeah, I mean, it's a good outcome. It's a good outcome, and we're talking about degrees. You know, there's a little thing here and a little thing there, but overall, I think the big things are really good. So nice passing. All right, you know, here we are in the 4-2, and we've got Rutgers kind of stacked over here. They're going to leave the D open, and they're kind of, you know, making it hard to get a good look at the server here because I think their block is going to stay in this half. So just, you know, a good pass that allows us to really, you know, create some space, look at nice and balanced the contact, create some space over there on the D, and we get a good side out. Here we are. Cease, tell me about that one.
I think I was, like, set up well, and that's totally my ball. I do think I can go more to the ball rather than to the side, really working to cut it off and try to stay off my knee.
Yeah. Yeah, and just, you know, I think what Cece's speaking to is her move was this way. She sets up perpendicular to the server, but if she made that step maybe this way, she could have been a little more forward and balanced the contact. And there was a little moment of hesitation, but I agree. I think in that seam, you know, we'd like you to take that. But, yeah, again, we're talking degrees, but ideally maybe if the move was a little more this way, it could have been a little more repeatable. It turns out it worked out just fine. All right, tell me about that move, Cease. What's going on there?
Well, I knew that bro, after we had scouted, I knew that she pretty much always serves straight lines. So I pretty much saw where she was setting up, and then I made the move early so I could get ahead of it, and then mm-hmm. I was just simple at contact.
Yeah, that's good. And you know, there are obviously with a front row outside hitter, you're going to start squeezing that player a little bit. And so it was nice to see that. But what a great read to get over here and make a good pass over from, you know, kind of 5-6 over back over to 1-6. And that's what ultimately we want you to do. See it and go get it. Reading is the premier skill in the game. There's no doubt about it. Well, very good. All right, let's have another look.
Well, I think I was forward. At contact, I think I can stay off my knee. Mm-hmm. But other than that, my platform was pretty simple at contact. So I was able to create a good angle.
Yeah. Yeah, and I mean, you go to your knee after contact. It's, you know, it's not the end of the world, but I understand what you're saying. Once you commit a knee, once you're down on one, it's hard to adjust and move. So you certainly want to be able to adapt to any last kind of millisecond float movement or anything that can happen with the serve. Looking pretty balanced here and then deep into the corner. Tell me about that.
I think I can try to get ahead of it more and get my arms going first because I feel like I kind of swung out. Mm-hmm. I committed my platform in front of me and then I swung out. I mean, it happened to be a good result, but in order for it to be repeatable, I got to get my arms going first.
Yeah, and I think just I'd agree with you. And again, you know, it works out just fine. But we're talking about repeatability. Can we be good over time? And generally when you're swinging out to things, it's much harder to be repeatable versus getting your platform out there ahead of it. The other thing that I really like was the way you two worked that seam. Can you talk, Didi, a little bit, Adonna, how you and Cease manage that seam, you know, especially when you're front row there, but you pass together all year. I mean, tell me about the communication or how you guys work it.
I think when I'm front row, I take more short stuff and I'm squeezed more so uh-huh. that I don't take as many balls and choose more deep. But if it comes straight to me or something like that, or like one step beside me, yeah. I'll usually take it. But if I'm in one, I'll usually take the deep seam kind of like this way, and then short seam, obviously, like if like the middles or the right sides are stacked up there. And then when I'm in six, it's usually like a short deep type of thing as well. And I'm usually squeezing the outside, the other outside.
Right.
So I think we talk that way, just seams.
Good. Cece, anything to add there?
Yeah, I think basically whenever there's the front row outside, I mean, trying to free them up as much as possible so they can do their job in the front row and get us a kill. So trying to make their job a lot easier.
Right. And this is a question for both of you. I mean, you know, in terms of passing, you know, again, the goal is a good pass. You know, what kind of things do you think are technically, you know, effective for you? What kind of things are you, a couple of things that you're working on that you think help you to get the results, to get the outcomes that we're looking for?
Well, for me, one thing I'm still working on is leading with my arms, getting my arms going first. Mm-hmm. Because oftentimes the ball's coming at a pretty good pace at this level, so you might not be able to get your body there. So as long as your arms and your platform's in the line, mm-hmm. you'll make a consistent angle to target. So that's one thing that's helping me, like, improve to be a more efficient passer.
Okay. Okay. Didi, you got anything you want to add to that? Or from your end?
Oh, yes. For me, I think it's more about staying down throughout the pass and not popping up as much. And also getting my feet moving, because, like, sometimes I just use my long arms to, you know, save me. But trying to get my feet to move will be helpful.
Yeah, and I think for both of you, obviously, you know, you come to Minnesota and we ask that you make some changes, you know, that we try to clean up your mechanics. And both of you have really great feel for the ball underhand, and for large portions of your career, you were able to get away with that. You know, having great feel was enough. But as you get further up the volleyball food chain, you know, as the serving gets better and the margins get thinner, then, you know, these mechanical efficiencies, these layers of biomechanical efficiency and the idea of creating repeatability become more and more critical. So certainly kudos to both of you for embracing that process of change, you know, because none of that's easy, especially when you're good at doing it the way you used to do it. But here you are, you know, adding layers of mastery every year and continuing to be better in this really critical phase of the game, both on the serving and the passing side of it. So, well, listen, thanks everyone for checking in with us. We hope you enjoyed our little insight into serving and passing. Like I said, really critical part of the game. If you can win the serve-serve-receive battle, you'll win most of your matches. And remember, serving is about accuracy. It doesn't have to be about aces. Again, we don't mind them, but that shouldn't be the goal. It should be trying to knock your opponents out of system and passing-wise. Make sure you're getting there. Make a good angle. Give us a good enough pass so we can sense something we can take a swing at. All right. Thanks, everybody. That's it from the University of Minnesota on Serve and Pass. Go big, stay safe and healthy, and all the best.